Welcome to the eighth video of Quantum Mechanics Done Right, the shortest path from novice to researcher. In this chapter, chapter four, we talk about the advanced quantum mechanics of light, and we have some just incredibly cool things to talk about. Here I'm showing you an experiment that's called a quantum seeing in the dark experiment. It actually allows you to look at things without shining any light on it. And you can only do that with quantum mechanics, and it's just a really cool concept. So chapter four is the advanced quantum mechanics of light. We start off by talking about the Mach-Zehnder interferometer and motivating the ideas behind how you can do a quantum seeing in the dark experiment. We then describe an extra degree of freedom of light called polarization by manipulating the spatial dependence or the spatial state of light. Along with its polarization, you can create entangled states, and this allows you to do the watched experiments of a two-slit experiment without disturbing the photon at all by using polarizers as your detectors on the individual slits. And it's really cool to see and understand how when you create an entangled state by using polarizers, all your interference goes away. But by modifying the polarization just before you measure it, you can get the interference back. And it's one of the most mind-blowing things about quantum mechanics, and it's really cool. We talk about that in this chapter. We talk about quantum seeing in the dark, another incredibly cool experiment. It allows you to see an object without shining any light on it, not a single photon. That's just incredibly cool. You can take it into another extreme where you can use it for communication, where you can communicate to someone without exchanging any photons, which is also just a mind-blowing kind of idea. We then discuss another really important many-body physics effect called the Hongu-Mandel effect. This is an effect that allows us to experimentally verify that two photons that have the same color and have the same polarization are identical, and when they are identical, they like to bunch together. And again, this is another kind of mind-blowing quantum mechanical idea. The Hongu-Mandel effect is a very important effect in much of quantum information science. When something new like a new qubit comes out, or when one is looking at many kinds of new phenomena, often the Hongu-Mandel effect will be one of the first types of experiments that they'll try and do with this new device to verify that it's actually operating in the way that it's supposed to operate. All right, let's go browse through the chapter. I start this chapter off with a quote from one of my favorite musicians, Bob Dylan. It's not dark yet, but it's getting there. We start by describing how you could use a two-slit experiment to do an interaction-free measurement. That entails being able to see the obstruction in one of the slits with a photon that does not actually hit the obstruction. It's an interesting idea about how you can do that. And it is unfortunately incredibly inefficient, so most of the time this isn't going to work well. But if you're lucky, you know, maybe 0.1% of the time you can actually detect an obstruction without actually looking at it. But a much more efficient way of doing it is with a Mach-Zehnder interferometer. And to understand a Mach-Zehnder interferometer, you need to understand its components. And one of them is a beam splitter. Beam splitters essentially look like partially reflecting sunglasses. So you're all familiar with them, but they're put together in a particular arrangement that then allows you to do interesting experiments. You get interference patterns that are complementary to each other at the two different detectors, one called the bright detector, the other called the dark detector. In this case, the one here on the left is the bright detector because it has a bright spot in the center, and the one on the left is the dark detector because it has a dark spot in the center. Then there's lots of things you can do with Mach-Zehnder interferometers. You can play with changing the path lengths, you can play with rotating polarization, you can play with putting other obstructions inside, you can use polarizers. There's lots of interesting things you can do with Mach-Zehnder interferometers. in order to understand how you can see something without shining any light on it, you need to understand the quantum Zeno effect. So we first talk about the philosopher Zeno and his notions of infinity and how you can get into what is called the quantum Zeno effect. And we typically do this with polarization. And there's lots of interesting things and experiments you can do with polarization. Here, this is done with a diffraction about a wire, but it's very similar to a two-slit experiment with polarizers. You can see that if you put polarizers on the device, the diffraction pattern, which is in panel A, gets lost in panel B when you put cross polarizers on either side of the wire. Then by tuning the polarizers, you can get the light from one of the sides or the other side. And then by putting it at 45 degrees, you can get the interference pattern to recur and come back. It's really quite amazing. This is a delayed choice experiment. It's actually fairly easy to do, very easy to understand, and it has a lot of quantum mechanics in it. We then move on to describe the sort of guts of how the quantum seeing in the dark experiment will work. It requires us to understand something called a polarization rotator and what happens with a rotator when you have polarizers and you intersperse them, as was shown in that figure. And then eventually we get to the true quantum seeing in the dark experiment. We got a lot of problems here. Polarization has a lot of interesting things that you can talk about. But here we are with it. We need to use a device called a polarizing beam splitter. It acts just like the beam splitter, but it will reflect horizontally polarized light and transmit the vertically polarized light. So it acts in some sense like a switch that is built off of the polarization. And by using that, you can create this remarkable experiment that will allow you to see an obstruction that will be placed on that vertical line between the polarizing beam splitter and the mirror. And you can see whether it is there or whether it is not there. I can't go through all of the details behind that in this short lecture. There's a number of concepts you need to get, but it is really cool, and I think you'll enjoy it when you read it in the book. And then we talk about the Hongu-Mandel experiment and photon bunching. This is also a really cool experiment. It started off with something called the Hanbury-Brown and Twiss experiment that allowed astronomers to measure the angular size of stars by looking at the same star with two different telescopes and correlating the brightness and the darkness and the fluctuations of the light between the two telescopes. And then to get the Hongu-Mandel effect, what you do is you have an experiment shown in this bottom panel where you have two sources of light going onto a beam splitter and you have two detectors. And the question is, do I see the light going into one detector only, or do I see the light going into both detectors? And this dip is that you see the light going into only one detector, not in both detectors, when you get the two photons to completely align with each other and be identical photons going through your device. It's like one of the cool things in the second quantum revolution, these kinds of experiments. So of course we have some different kinds of problems, and then that takes us to the end of chapter 4. Hey guys, let's do quantum right.